All right.
So now that we've got the intercooler in and we're almost ready to go back to the water and test, we're going to put the soleless impeller in. The stock impeller's got to go. Thing's got dings and chips and stuff in it all over it. So we're going to pull the pump out, remove the prop, and we're also going to add the Riva strainer with the extra outlet, and we're going to run an extra cooling line into the hull so we can power, or not power, but cool the intercooler, the bigger intercooler, with its own source of pumping water from the pump. So let's get that thing out. All right, so pretty simple to get this thing out. Four big bolts, just disconnect your connections, and here's the whole pump assembly all in one chunk. So here's our factory impeller. You can see it's got some damage. It's beat up pretty good. No doubt this was causing some cavitation and some vibration. So, and you can see it's pitted right at the root here. It's pitted pretty bad. So cavitation for sure from that kind of condition. Those little air pockets always cause, or not little air pockets, but voids always cause air pockets to produce as this thing spins up. Hopefully this comes off with a little bit of ease, and we'll lube this whole shaft back up, put that back in, and then the strainer gets replaced. So we're gonna take that off, put the Riva one on. It's got a fitting on it with an extra water line, and then we'll go here, and we're gonna have to drill a hole right here through the hull, and we'll put a through hole fitting there so that the water has a nice passage to go through. And I'm also gonna tap and plug this. This is the visibility spout, which we're not using. So that just reduces any excess water from coming out of the pump. We want it all to be creating pressure to push. So we'll take that out also in the same stroke as all the other stuff. I'm on to you, Chris. We're over here at Riva. And I see something. This one right here. You got some explaining to do, buddy. You got some explaining to do. All right, we're back at the house. You guys are gonna hate me, but I had to skip a whole bunch of stuff, and I'll explain why. I had some trouble with the ski. So, after we got everything off, I couldn't get the prop off of the shaft. Couldn't get the impeller off of the shaft. No matter how hard, I mean, the thing, I was jumping with a breaker bar. I was literally jumping on the end of a breaker bar with the thing in a vise, and I couldn't get it to budge. So I ended up having to cut the impeller off, which you guys can imagine is an ordeal in itself. But I did get it off. I put the new prop on, brought it back, and ran into problem number two. And that was, it didn't fit. So, I mean, it's the right size impeller, 155 millimeter, but it wouldn't go into the wear ring. And it's because the wear ring was actually warped and swollen, having some trouble. So they get old, they get dissimilar metal corrosion in between the liner and the stainless steel ring, because this is aluminum with a stainless steel liner. So I went in there and I tried to burr it down and grind on it a little bit and make it fit. And I got it okay, but it just bothered me that, you know, you can see the pitting and stuff that I had to get rid of and stuff. So it just bothered me that I had to do that. So we ran down to Riva and picked up a new wear ring. This is a stainless steel wear ring, completely stainless steel, so there's no liner. It's solid stainless steel, and it won't have that problem ever again. And we put that back on, and lo and behold, she's good. So I just sealed this up. You can see, well, maybe you can't see. You can't see much. But you can see the, let me put this down, there you go. You can see I put on that strainer right there, the pump strainer with the fitting, and I ran a line, and we ran a bulkhead fitting there. There's the new liner housing. You can see that nice stainless there. And blocked off the visibility spout. So did quite a few things. We're pretty much ready to rock now. New impeller is in. Not touching anything, see light all around it, it's good to go. Oh man, what a job. Oh, did I mention I did all this in a pouring rain? Yeah. I'm a glutton for punishment. Sometimes I just have to get something done. Rather than being a smart guy and pulling the ski to the shop and doing it in the shop with all my tools and everything, I decided to do it at the house because I know it's not a very difficult job if it goes right. But anyway, we got it. So we've got the intercooler on, the prop is in, and we're gonna run the extra cooling for the strainer, pump strainer, to the intercooler. So let's go ahead and button this sucker up and see if we have enough time in the day when I'm done with that. Looks pretty decent to go to the water. Let's give it a try. All right, we're loaded up. We're ready to head to the water. Man, I love the way this ski looks. It's like, I don't know. It doesn't look that crazy, but it's just a great ski. I love it. Look at good old boy. He's good, of course. Okay, so we're gonna head to the water now. Do a little testing. See how it sits. Now, we haven't put the hull tech in yet, so we're still limited on RPM. So we'll see if this prop still achieves similar speeds at similar RPMs. If it does, and we've gained hole shot, gained acceleration, then we're doing good. That's the name of the game. I wanted to see some a little bit better acceleration, no cavitation, and similar RPM versus prop speed. So that's gonna prove to me that when we put the hull tech in and we put the bigger blower in, we're just gonna shoot past that 65 or 66 miles an hour that we were able to hit before. And we'll go straight deep into the 70s, hopefully, with a lot of hole shot. Go. Let's see what we did. Now I got a 3/4 of a tank of fuel, 66 miles an hour. So there you go. About a 2 mile an hour gain GPS. And I think that we're on the rev limiter now. The speedometer was dancing at 69.70. So a little bit, about a 4 mile an hour, 3 mile an hour discrepancy. But all in all, good. The mods are working, so by that math, if we're at 66 now at 7,700 RPM actually, then when we open up the rev limiter another 900, 800 RPM, that should get us another 8 or 9 miles an hour on top. So we'll be deep in the 70s just like that. That's good. That's what we want to see. And then we can adjust the prop a little bit to get us closer to 80. So all in all, really good. Happy with that.
a little bit crowded here right now, but I could try and do it the other way just to verify. There's tubers over there, there's four skis, skis everywhere in this place, so I'm gonna go ahead and call it there. But just so you know, there is no wind. It is dead still. You can see the trees. They're not moving. It's dead still, dead calm. There's no current here, so I guarantee you that's an actual speed. It's really good. So hopefully the haul tech comes next week. That's what we want to see. And then we'll go up. I'm gonna go back and pick up Carla now.